the sanctified life saddened by poisonous errors. John lived to see the gospel of Christ preached far and near, and thousands eagerly accepting its teachings. But he was filled with sadness as he perceived poisonous errors creeping into the church. Some who accepted Christ claimed that his love released them from obedience to the law of God. On the other hand, many thought that the letter of the law should be kept, also all the Jewish customs and ceremonies, and that this was sufficient for salvation without the blood of Christ. They held that Christ was a good man like the apostles, but denied his divinity. John saw the dangers to which the church would be exposed should they receive these ideas, and he met them with promptness and decision. He wrote to a most honorable helper in the gospel, a lady of good repute and extensive influence. Many deceivers are entered into the world who confess not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh. This is a deceiver and an antichrist. Look to yourselves that we lose not those things which we have wrought, but that we receive a full reward. Whosoever transgresseth and abideth not in the doctrine of Christ hath not God. He that abideth in the doctrine of Christ, he hath both the Father and the Son. If there come any unto you, and bring not this doctrine, receive him not into your house, neither bid him Godspeed, for he that biddeth him Godspeed is partaker of his evil deeds. 2 John verses 7 through 11. John was not to prosecute his work without great hindrances. Satan was not idle. He instigated evil men to cut short the useful life of this man of God, but holy angels protected him from their assaults. John must stand as a faithful witness for Christ. The church in its peril needed his testimony. By misrepresentation and falsehood, the emissaries of Satan had sought to stir up opposition against John and against the doctrine of Christ. In consequence, dissensions and heresies were imperiling the church. John met these errors unflinchingly. He hedged up the way of the adversaries of truth. He wrote and exhorted that the leaders in these heresies should not have the least encouragement. There are at the present day evils similar to those that threaten the prosperity of the early church, and the teachings of the apostle upon this point should be carefully heeded. You must have charity is the cry to be heard everywhere, especially from those who profess sanctification. But charity is too pure to cover an unconfessed sin. John's teachings are important for those who are living amid the perils of the last days. He had been intimately associated with Christ. He had listened to his teachings and had witnessed his mighty miracles. He bore a convincing testimony which made the falsehoods of his enemies of none effect. The Sanctified Life, Chapter 8, The Ministry of John.